Why did General Robert E. Lee lose the Battle of Gettysburg? Now there's a question that stoked the fires of debate for more than a century and a half. Let us delve into the events leading up to and during the Battle of Gettysburg to better understand the circumstances that led to the Confederate defeat. It's the summer of 1863, and the American Civil War is in full swing. General Robert E. Lee, the commander of the Confederate Army of Northern Virginia, decides to launch a second invasion of the North. His aim? To draw the Union Army away from Virginia, and in doing so, relieve the pressure on the Confederate capital of Richmond. The plan seems solid, but as the saying goes, the best laid plans of mice and men often go awry. The Union Army, commanded by General George G. Meade, and Lee's Confederate forces converge in the small town of Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. Over the next 3 days, from July 1st to July 3rd, the town becomes the stage for one of the bloodiest battles in American history. On the first day, the Confederates enjoy initial success, pushing Union forces back through the town. But the Union forces establish a strong defensive position on Cemetery Hill. On the second day, the Confederates attempt to flank the Union line, but they are met with fierce resistance. The third day brings about the climax of the battle. Lee, against the advice of his trusted lieutenant, General James Longstreet, orders a direct assault on the center of the Union line. This assault, known as Pickett's Charge, ends in disaster for the Confederates. Over half of the men are killed, wounded, or captured, and the Confederates are forced to retreat. So, why did General Lee lose the Battle of Gettysburg? The reasons are manifold. Firstly, Lee's decision to launch Pickett's Charge, despite Longstreet's opposition, was a significant factor. The direct assault on a well-fortified enemy was a gamble that did not pay off. Secondly, the absence of accurate intelligence played a role. Lee's cavalry, under the command of the flamboyant General Jeb Stuart, was absent in the days leading up to the battle. Stuart's role was to screen the Confederate army and provide valuable information about enemy movements. Without Stuart's cavalry, Lee was, in a sense, blind. Lastly, the Union Army's strong defensive position, coupled with the leadership of General Meade, certainly contributed to their victory. The Union forces held the high ground, giving them an advantage in both visibility and artillery range. In conclusion, the Battle of Gettysburg was a turning point in the American Civil War. General Lee's loss was a combination of risky decisions, lack of intelligence, and the strength of the Union defense. It's a stark reminder that even the most seasoned and respected commanders can falter under the right circumstances. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please leave a comment and share it with friends. Hit the like button and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.